In Affinity Photo's new 2.6 version, we finally got the Smart Selection tool, which was frequently asked for by the community. It uses machine learning to help you quickly creating selections and masks. In this video, I will compare it to Adobe Photoshop's object selection in several different categories. To enable the Smart Selection in Affinity, you will have to go to the Machine Learning tab in the Settings and install those models. Let's start with a photography that features a landscape and a hot air balloon. When using the Smart Selection tool in Affinity, you will first have to wait a while for it to initialize everything. When hovering over anything, it will almost instantly give you a rough preview of the selection. This way, the selection feels more real-time than in Photoshop, since you get a better understanding of what kind of details get picked up by the AI. Let's try selecting the balloon. We have to select the balloon and the basket individually, and those strings holding them together seem to be too fine to be picked up by the AI. In Photoshop, you don't have to wait for the tool to initialize, but the previews feel more rough than in Affinity. But Photoshop actually understands that the balloon and the basket belong together. But again, the strings are not being picked up by the AI. But as you can see, Photoshop is overall less responsive performance-wise, even though I have GPU acceleration enabled. But keep in mind that I'm recording, so the performance suffers a bit because of that. I think overall both applications bring pretty much equal results in this scenario, so let's head on to the next example. In this example, we got the worst enemy of any selection tool, small hairs. And Affinity really has no interest in picking them up. Both softwares separate the basket and the person in the picture. Let's try the select subject operation in both applications. Affinity Photo Selection is pretty much the same as if you would have done it with the tool yourself. In Photoshop, on the other hand, selection is perfect. This time it understood that the basket belongs to the person and it even was able to deal with the small hairs. It also kept that little gap in mind. I think, result-wise, this round clearly goes to Photoshop. For the next example, I have a CG render I have created. The tool in Affinity gives you a much better idea of what the AI recognizes. Both softwares didn't pick up the wine glass, but I guess that is kind of hard to recognize for an AI. When selecting the wine bottle, both programs were able to pick it up. Affinity struggled with the highlights of it, while Photoshop was able to understand them. Both softwares were able to select the books, but Photoshop's selection was a bit better since it didn't leave as many gaps. Affinity was able to separate the carpet and the floor, while Photoshop put them together, which might not be in your favor. In conclusion, I would say both applications did not perform too good. For example, none of them were able to understand the window. Also, both programs had different advantages. Let's try selecting elements of a user interface. Photoshop only gave me the selection of a 3D model as a preview, while Affinity gave a lot more previews. I was able to get a few more selections in Photoshop by drawing rectangles with the tool. Both applications were not really able to pick up icons or text elements, but Photoshop was able to give a pretty good selection of the gizmo, and even left gaps for the letters. I think overall this round goes to Affinity Photo, although Photoshop really surprised me with the clean selection of the gizmo. Now we have a screenshot of Cyberpunk to see how it handles video game content, which usually offers a mix of a bit more stylized 3D graphics and HUD elements. Affinity Photo had a better understanding of several details in the image. For example, Photoshop had a problem with the volumetric lighting, which is this pink scattered light. It also struggled with this transparent HUD element because you could see a part of the leg from this bouncer behind it. Affinity Photo was better at selecting the bouncer, in my opinion. When I tried selecting the minimap, both selections were kinda similar, but I think Photoshop's selection was a bit better. But I think this round goes to Affinity Photo again. For the final scene, I have a frame of Tokyo Ghoul to see how the programs perform on anime content. And in this scenario, Affinity Photo really outperformed Photoshop for some reason. Affinity Photo was much better at understanding what kind of objects belong together, and it even was able to pick up smaller details like the metal bars in the background. It was really interesting to me how Photoshop didn't really understand what is happening in this image at all. In an overall conclusion, it feels like Affinity Photo's Smart Selection is better at separating an image into multiple segments, while Photoshop was much better at understanding and processing fine details like hair. So the tools both have their own advantages, and apparently Photoshop is better at working with photographies, while Affinity Photo was better at stylized work. So I think you could say that Photoshop's selection is more specialized, while Affinity's selection is kind of a generalist. Also, the Smart Selection Infinity Photo is very new, so maybe it will be a completely different story in a few months or a year. But we will have to see what the future brings. Let's also don't forget how much smoother the experience was in Infinity Photo. If you enjoyed this comparison, I would love if you would support me by subscribing to this channel. See ya!